So, what is Magento? Magento is one of the most popular open source e-commerce CMS platforms at the moment. This might sound like a bunch of jargon to you right off the bat, as it did for me at one point. So let's help you break this down. Magento, open source e-commerce CMS platform. Open source is software in which the source code is released under a license, where the holder allows users the right to enhance, alter, and modify this code in any way they see fit to meet their needs. In simple terms, it's essentially free code. Pretty cool, huh? E-commerce software, as most of you know, is software that allows commercial transactions to be conducted electronically. In other words, an application used to sell products and services online. Now, what about those three random letters I threw out there? CMS. CMS stands for Content Management System. A CMS is an application used to manage all content related to a product or service in one central location. So, there you have it. Magento is an open source e-commerce content management system. Magento was started by this guy named Roy Rubin. Roy was an ordinary student, just trying to make some extra cash on the side. But instead of waiting tables or pouring cocktails, he founded a company in 2004 to fund his student lifestyle. This company was called Varian. Roy didn't really have a vision for the company at the time, not really what they teach you at business school. But for him, it was something he was doing to maintain his competency level while continuing to learn and grow professionally. So, from 2004, Varian went from no master plan whatsoever to launching Magento in 2008, which now powers billions of dollars in sales. Fast forward a few years to 2011, eBay buys 49% share of Magento, followed by the entire acquisition a mere 4 months later. Roy remained CEO of Magento for 2 years before stepping down and leaving the company. I think he planted some pretty good roots there, considering their impressive numbers. For example, 2 years ago, Magento accounted for approximately 30% of the total market share. Last year, in 2019, $155 billion worth of goods were sold through Magento-based systems alone. Today, the platform source code has been downloaded more than 2.5 million times, and more than 100,000 online stores have been created on this platform. These online stores are a mix of B2B and B2C, small, medium, and enterprise businesses. Some of these include Coca-Cola, Nike, Ford, and Warby Parker, just to name a few. These are giant, dominant, multi-million and multi-billion dollar companies putting their trust in Magento to run their online businesses. So, if Magento serves these types of companies, you can imagine the extent of their features, customization options, and scalability potential there is for small and medium-sized businesses out there. From the ability to engage with content, to managing your orders and inventory, to shipping and even providing customer service, Magento really is a one-stop shop for all e-commerce business needs. They truly allow you to create an engaging, full lifecycle shopping experience unique to your brand, no matter the size or the goals of your business. So, if you're looking to start your own e-commerce store or wanting to switch your current platform app that you may not be satisfied with, check Magento out. There are two versions, one free version and one paid version. I know what you're thinking. I just explained that open source essentially means free coding. And it does. Don't get me wrong. The free version, which used to be called community, but now goes by open source, frankly is perfect for most size businesses. Here at IWD, we've helped small startups all the way through to large multi-million dollar companies on this free version. You can do so much with it. The paid version of Magento, which used to be called Enterprise and now goes by Commerce, is targeted more at larger e-commerce companies, generally doing more than $1 million a year online. So let's be honest, When we get to this level of sales, I think we can all agree that Magento isn't asking too much from us to pay for their source code at that point. Well, there you have it. We hope you found this information on Magento useful. If you did, give us a thumbs up below, leave us your feedback and comments. We'd love to hear from you. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for checking us out. Until next time.